Well, good morning, everybody, and welcome to today's webinar on Instagram for agents. Unfortunately, the actual live webinar we did didn't record properly. So this is round two. So this isn't going to include any of the audience interaction, anything like that. But that's all right. This will be the nice Cole's Notes version of our Instagram webinar. Very exciting. This webinar was the first time we also live streamed on Periscope as well, using Remax of Western Canada's Periscope account, which is the handle at Remax Western Can. In the future, we're probably going to do this as well. So if you follow Remax Western Canada on Twitter, there will be a live link that goes out right before the webinar is broadcast, and there will be that opportunity for these social media webinars to tune in and watch the live feed as well. A big thank you to all of those who tuned in both on the live webinar earlier and the Periscope feed as well. We had just over 70 viewers, I think, total on Periscope. So great numbers, great to see that. For those of you who haven't seen one of my webinars or recorded videos in the past, my name is Wade Patterson, and I'm the Social Media and Communications Coordinator with RE/MAX of Western Canada. If you ever have any questions or you want to chat about social media or communications, please feel free to reach out to me. You can get me by email, wpatterson@remax.net, and you can also contact me at our head office here in Kelowna. That number is 1-800-563-3622. If you're on Twitter or Periscope, my handle is at Patterson Wade. You can get me there as well. Also, as always, for our social media webinars, we are using the hashtag REMAX Social. And so if there's anything on this recorded video that you see that you like, feel free to throw out a tweet using that hashtag. We're always keeping an eye on it and very much appreciate you connecting with that conversation that way. We're going to cover a few topics in today's webinar, and if you're brand new to Instagram, I think there's going to be a lot of value in today's webinar for you. We're going to go over a lot of the basics, but even if you're pretty familiar with Instagram, I think you'll still find some value in this webinar as well. We're going to explain why this might be an app and form of social media that you want to consider being a part of. And I'm also going to give you a few tips and tools that might benefit you and make Instagram a lot more useful for you. So I want to start off by giving a bit of a background about Instagram. So the app was launched on October 6th, 2010, and it grew to 1 million users just over 2 months later. In 2011, Instagram was named Apple's iPhone App of the Year. In April 2012, Instagram became available for Android, and later that month, Facebook bought Instagram for $1 billion. This is interesting, really, because at the time, people were saying that's a lot of money for a company with no revenue. However, Gary Vaynerchuk, who many of you may have heard of, marketing genius, some would call him, has pointed out when you consider that Facebook paid $19 billion for WhatsApp short time later, $1 billion may have been quite the bargain to consider. And in December 2014, Instagram grew to 300 million monthly users, which is currently what it lists its user count as. So what's the purpose of being on Instagram? Well, for this description, I have to credit Katie Lance. And Katie Lance is the CEO and owner of Katie Lance Consulting. I'm sure many of you have heard of Katie before, but if you haven't, be sure to follow her on Instagram and Twitter at Katie Lance. Katie's message is that Instagram is a great way to personally connect with clients and showcase moments of the real estate process by taking snapshots that go beyond the listing photo. I think this is key because, like any social media network, originality and interesting content are super, super important. Since Instagram is so visual, think about photos that you can take that are interesting. So rather than just posting your standard listing photo, think, does this house have any cool or unique attributes that you could post in an Instagram photo? Rather than posting a photo of a house, straight on front view of a house, writing sold in the description, get a photo of the happy client standing in front of their new house. Maybe they're unlocking the door for the first time. Or how about putting or having the sellers put the sold sign on your yard sign? It's moments like these involving real people that are going to have much better engagement on Instagram. And to take this a step further, I'd actually recommend that agents really think about how they can showcase a community more than just an individual house being bought and sold. So are there any cool unique coffee shops in the neighborhood perhaps? Or are there any interesting or historic buildings that maybe have a story to tell? You know, you're going to have to be a little creative if you want to be delivering the best content on social media and do some thinking outside the box. And think about selling an entire neighborhood, an entire lifestyle, rather than just one house at a time. Another reason why you may want to be on Instagram is that the engagement ratio is pretty impressive. So to illustrate this, I provided an example, and I admit this is a bit of an apples to oranges comparison, but I think it still highlights the point that Instagram engagement is significant. So on the screen, you're going to see a post that was done on our Instagram account, on our Facebook account, and on Twitter. In Facebook, so what this is all about, a few months ago, Remax was involved in, there was a world record attempt to get the most inflated hot air balloons inside a closed stadium. And Remax had three balloons that were part of that competition. And I think they got something like 40 balloons in the AT&T Stadium in Dallas. So what we did is we posted an album on Facebook with 7 photos. On Twitter, we put 3 photos out. And on Instagram, just threw one photo out there, kind of explaining what this was. On Instagram, we saw that it had 12 likes, which might not seem like a lot, but one thing to consider is that Remax Western Canada's Instagram account is less than a year old, and we have 95 followers right now. So if you look at it from that point of view, not considering hashtags or anything like that, we got 12 likes out of 95 followers, which is about 12.6% interaction. On Facebook, we got a few more likes. We got 14, but Facebook tells us that post was seen by 581 people, so that equates to only a 2.4% interaction ratio or rate. And on Twitter, as you can see, kind of crashed and burned, a bit of a fail, 0 favorites or retweets. Again, apples to oranges comparison because you don't know. This could have had to do with the number of photos posted, could have had to do with the description, time of day these were posted. However, there is a bit of research that backs up this example as well. And again, I guess tip of the hat to Katie Lance for pointing this out in her recent Instagram webinar. Forrester Research determined that Instagram's engagement ratio was 60 times greater than Facebook, 60 times, and 140 times greater than Twitter in a study it conducted. Now, in that study, it looked at 2,500 brand posts across 7 major social networks. So I think the high rates of engagement are another big reason why Instagram is a social media network you might want to look at. And it's also worth pointing out that more and more internet usage is happening on mobile devices. So since Instagram is really built for mobile, the popularity of that app is likely to increase. Sticking with the why Instagram portion of this webinar, I think that this is a great network because of the ability to connect with your clients, potential clients, or even related conversations that are happening through hashtags. I'm going to go through some of the mechanics of Instagram later on, but for those of you who are new to Instagram, the search function is the second button at the bottom of the screen. So it's that little magnifying glass you see. And when you first click on that button, you're going to see a bunch of photos, like is illustrated in the photo on the left. And if you swipe over to people, Instagram gives you suggested accounts that you might want to consider following. Now this can be helpful because there may be those people you simply didn't know were on Instagram, but who you'd like to be following. If you click on the actual search function at the top, the screen will change to something like what you see on the right. From there, you'll be able to search for people or certain hashtags, and this is helpful for a couple of reasons. In the example, I typed real estate, and you can see that real estate has more than 30,000 posts. However, hashtag real estate agent has 116,000 posts. And the hashtags that are most popular might be worth including in the photos you upload, because these are ranking high on a search, and there's a good chance that others will be checking these out. So you could search for people. You can also search for people. So if you have a few clients who you're wanting to connect with on Instagram, you can search their names and you may be able to track them down as well. Hashtag searching might also work out for you to find out who is posting in your particular region and or neighborhood. And this is a really cool trick. So it may give you an opportunity to strategically like some posts you know are local. As an example, if I search hashtag West Kelowna, currently there are just under 7,000 posts. Well, if someone is using that hashtag, you can almost guarantee either they live in West Kelowna or they're visiting West Kelowna and they're posting a photo there in real time. So it's just kind of a unique way of putting yourself out there. If you go ahead and like someone's photo or you comment or something like that, they're going to see that that's a different name. They might go check out your profile. A good way to connect with people in that way. If you're currently a user on Instagram, you may have noticed lately there's more and more advertisements that are coming up. And it's not a crazy number, but they're starting to appear now. I think Heineken recently had one. There's a few other brands who have been getting in on it. This started last year. Instagram kind of announced that it would be unveiling this, but it's been very slow to open up. Not just anyone can advertise because they want to make sure that the content is still creative and engaging. So the current advertisement on the screen here, that's kind of the format how they're going to look. So there's a photo. It shows the account where the photo is coming from in the top left hand corner, and then in the top right it says sponsored, and that identifies what you're seeing is an ad. If you've experimented with Facebook advertising, it might be worth keeping an eye on Instagram advertising as it develops. It's tough to say how effective it will be. However, considering the incredible engagement numbers that Instagram currently boasts, it may do pretty well. But rather than wait until Instagram advertising is available for everyone, it's still worth creating an account and seeing what you can do organically for free. Remember that the most effective posts, whether you're advertising or whether you are posting just from your own account, will still definitely require creative thinking. So we've gone through a bunch of the why should I be on Instagram questions, and now I want to move into some of the functionality of using the app. So if you haven't figured it out by now, Instagram is an app that is accessed through your smartphone. So once you download the app, you have the opportunity to either log in if you already have an account, or you can sign up by entering your Facebook or email account. When choosing your username, I suggest putting in something that is relatively easy to be searched. It's always a good idea to include your name or business, depending on what's available. I've also found it's clever when possible to create a username that's the same as your Twitter account, if that's available. That way, if clients are looking for you on multiple platforms, this makes the process a bit easier for them. And if you want to include your social media accounts on business cards or marketing material, it's better if you have one username and then you could just have that username and then have the little icons beside it, like the little Twitter icon, the little Instagram camera, all those things. Then you got one name for multiple accounts. For example, you might have noticed Remax Western Can is our handle for both Twitter and Instagram. My advice when you get started on any new social media network, though, is that you take time at the beginning of the process to make sure your profile is set up correctly. So this is the first stop for people who are trying to find your account or people who simply want to learn more about who you are. A couple other tips for setting up your profile: make sure you include a profile picture. And this is important because including your face is a huge way people are going to know if they came across the right account. If they see you, they know who you are, then boom, they'll start following you. Also include your name or business name when you edit your profile. And there's also a spot to include a website and a bio as well. I'd suggest doing this because Instagram, it's funny, you know, you can't include live links when you post descriptions under photos in Instagram. However, that is kind of the one spot to post one live link is within your profile. So you might as well have that link back to your website and hopefully drive a little bit of traffic that way. So as we all know, one of the coolest things about Instagram is that it has a built-in photo editing app. Instagram wants your photos to look awesome, and this built-in editing app does just that. One of the biggest instant effects you can make to your photos is by adding a filter, which is what you see at the bottom of this screenshot example. So play around, see how each of the filters makes your photos look. Personally, I'm a big fan of the early bird filter, and 80% of the time I'd say I think my photo is improved when I use that. Other people like Valencia, just depends. So try out a few, see what you like. You can also crop your photos, you can sharpen them, tilt them, adjust the brightness, contrast, saturation, highlights, shadows. That's a mouthful. A lot of things you can do with your photos to make them look better, and it can all be done very, very quickly, which is awesome. So after you hit next, you'll have the opportunity to add a caption, and it's here you can use hashtags, you can tag people, you can include other users' handles, and even push the photos to Facebook, Twitter, Tumblr, or Flickr if you have those connects, or sorry, those accounts connected to your Instagram account. Personally, and this is a personal choice for sure, but I like to keep Instagram photos on Instagram for the most part. Some agents push these elsewhere. I do it from time to time, but here's the reason I like to keep it on Instagram. I'm finding the more and more social media networks we're connecting with, you're following people on multiple networks, and I'm just seeing time and time again people posting the exact same thing on every network. And after a while, if seeing the same content over and over and over, it gets a little bit frustrating at times. And I like to think that if someone's following me on Instagram, there's an incentive for it. They're going to see things on Instagram that they might not see on my Facebook account, or they might not see on my Twitter account. And so that's kind of my attitude towards it. I think it's a bit of a personal choice, but that's my advice anyways. One of the anomalies with Instagram is the usage of hashtags. So on most social media platforms, the more people use hashtags, often the more annoying it gets. And after a certain point, it actually negatively affects engagement. But according to Track Maven research, the more hashtags, the better on Instagram. So as long as the hashtags you're using are effective and can be found by search, I'd really suggest that the sky is the limit. There are some people who still find tons of hashtags annoying, however, and it's becoming more and more common to see posts like the one on this screen. Sorry, however, it's becoming more and more common to see posts like the one on this screen. So for the number of people who find it annoying, I think there's many more benefits out of doing this on Instagram. So on the screen, you see a post by Tourism Kelowna, and it was at Okanagan Lavender Herb Farm. The post says almost harvest time. And then they have 12 hashtags underneath. Hashtag lavender field, hashtag lavender flowers, hashtag smell, hashtag summer, hashtag BC, on and on and on. Even though this looks a bit annoying, what they're doing by including all those hashtags is they're adding themselves to multiple searchable avenues. And the more of those you're in, the more chance people are going to come across your photos. And people do search for hashtags within Instagram. So this is perhaps a good strategy for getting your photos seen by more and more people. But you'll notice the format. They have their sentence and then they have all the hashtags clumped together at the bottom. From what I've seen on Instagram, this is kind of the effective way of including hashtags. So rather than trying to write a big long sentence with five hashtags sparsely included within it, I'd suggest have your sentence without any hashtags and then add all those hashtags at the bottom. From what I've seen, that's kind of the best practice. In the graph on the left, that's the research I was referring to by Track Maven. You can see 11 plus hashtags received the best interaction. So pretty interesting with hashtags and Instagram. The fourth button on Instagram allows you to check out your activity. So that includes people who have started following you, people who have liked your photo, people who have mentioned you, and/or people who have commented on your photo. And this is a super important tab to keep an eye on because you want to make sure you're acknowledging others' interaction. So if they commented with a question, you want to respond to that, or if someone starts following you, you may want to follow them back, or at least check out what their account is all about and then decide whether or not you want to follow him or her. I just quickly want to also speak about the last button, which sends you to your profile view. And these are all the photos you've ever uploaded to Instagram. From this screen, you have the option to edit your profile, or you can click the settings button, which is the little gear on the top right. A couple things I want to note. If you click on edit profile, from here you can make several changes, such as editing your profile picture, adding a website, adding a bio, changing your passwords, etc. But one important thing to note is that you can also choose whether or not posts are private. This is completely your call, and it's a privacy issue, privacy setting type thing, but I would suggest turning it off. And here's the reason. By turning it off, anyone can follow you, they can find your posts, and essentially it makes you a lot easier to connect with, which I think is a good thing. If your posts are private, if anyone wants to follow you, they have to submit a request, which you then have to approve before they can see your photos. And that extra step can be a deterrent for some people, and you may be hindering the number of people you're able to connect with. But with that said, you may not want just anyone able to see your photos. So that's a decision that's up to you. The other thing I'd note is by touching the settings button, you can also find a few other features such as finding others to follow, reviewing posts you've liked, or changing your share settings to other social networks. Another very cool feature about Instagram is it allows you to upload video clips, and these can be between 3 and 15 seconds long. And when your contacts scroll by the video clip on their screen, for most people that video will begin playing automatically without sound, which is great. You know, sometimes it's asking a lot for someone to actually click the play button on a video, but when it starts playing automatically, it has the chance to capture your attention, and then you will probably click and want to hear the sound that goes along with that video as well. 15 seconds might seem pretty short for a video, but keep in mind Vine videos, Vine very popular network, those are 6 seconds long, and it's pretty impressive how much information can be shared in that short of a time frame when a little creativity is used especially. Just like photos, there are ways you can instantly edit videos on Instagram as well. There are several filters to choose from, which are actually different than the photo filters. You can crop your video by clicking on the scissor icon, and you can also choose a cover frame. So speaking of going past the listing photo, utilizing video on Instagram is a great way to do that. So why not record the reactions of your clients when you tell them that their home is sold? Things like that. Use a little creativity. It's important for every form of social media, no different on Instagram, maybe even more important. So there are tons of apps out there that you may find beneficial to use on your photos or video before inserting them into Instagram. And this might take a little bit of exploration on your part to see what you like. The first one I want to point out, though, is Hyperlapse. Hyperlapse allows you to shoot video, and then you can change the speed in which that video plays back. You can do it at 1x, 2x, 4x, 6x, 10x, or 12x the speed. And this can have a cool effect in many situations. So one example, if you're in a crowded place, tons of people walking around, maybe a really busy mall or something, try standing still, shoot 1 minute of video using Hyperlapse. And then when you speed that up to 10 or 12 times, all of a sudden you have a video that's short enough, it's under 15 seconds, you can put that on Instagram, and it's a very interesting effect. It's all these people buzzing by, and it kind of tells a story on its own. And I've seen that type of technique done for sunsets, for storms, different things like that. Another cool thing about Hyperlapse is that it also acts as an image stabilization device. So if you're walking with your smartphone while shooting Hyperlapse, the video will actually appear quite a bit smoother than if you're just walking, shooting in normal video mode. Another tool you might find useful is PicFrame, and that's an app that allows you to select multiple photos and organize them into a layout that posts as a single collage image on Instagram. So sometimes you might have a couple photos you want to show at once, and although you can post them all individually on Instagram, some users, and I'm one of them to be honest, find it annoying when one person posts like 10 times in a row on Instagram. You're just scrolling and scrolling and essentially seeing just slightly different photos of the same subject. When someone overposts like that, that can turn people off. So just be aware of it. PicFrame might be a good solution. You can kind of have that collage effect to show multiple pictures in one Instagram photo. Again, many apps out there. The other one I'm just going to mention is one called Overgram. That allows you to add text to your Instagram photos, which can be useful for getting additional messages across. I know PicFrame also gives you the opportunity to add labels, but Overgram gives you a few more options. And this is pretty cool, exciting bit of news that came out literally 48 hours ago. Instagram announced on Monday that you can now search for people, places, and hashtags on the web. So previously, this was a function that you couldn't do on a desktop computer. It was all done on your smartphone. So perhaps if I haven't convinced you yet that Instagram's worth being on, maybe this is something to tip the scales, because I know sometimes searching and doing too much online stuff on my smartphone can be a little bit tedious. But you know, using a desktop for this function might allow you to do some of that research, such as searching hashtags, searching clients to connect with. Maybe one more reason you can consider Instagram. Thank you to everyone who has watched this webinar recording. Very much appreciated. Once again, my name is Wade Patterson. I'm the Social Media and Communications Coordinator with RE/MAX of Western Canada. If you have any questions or any comments at any time, please reach out to me, wpatterson@remax.net or 1-800-563-3622 and ask for Wade. Have a great day and good luck Instagramming.